Good morning, Ma'am Karen. Good morning to everyone.
All right. Now, while nothing is yet final, the fact is BuCor holds the title to 770 hectares of the Masungi Geo Reserve. So that's a very, very big property. Is that the only option where you can actually relocate and build new headquarters? Wala na po bang iba, sir?
There are so many options right now. But unfortunately, when I got hold of the proclamation 1158, the president then, Gloria Macapagal Arroyo, issued a proclamation giving us that parcel of land, and it stated that it will be a new site of the new Bilibid prison and the field office site of the DNR. So I was just following the instructions. However, with this development, with my boss, the Secretary of Justice, already saying that nothing is final, still have to be studied. My next move now is to ask the UP Urban Planning Center to help me, in as much as it was also stated during that interview by the Honorable Secretary that he's not telling BuCor what to do, and he's giving a free hand of BuCor to do its mandate.
Yeah.
So I have to consult the experts.
Yeah.
I'm not an expert in urban planning or in environment, so I'm asking our experts, some of them are from UP, to help us.
But does BuCor own any other piece of land in the Philippines?
We have been Davao, in Palawan, in Toro, and in other places. But knowing that this property is also ours, we have to look into it and make also a master planning, because given that a new development also, that the president already issued the Philippine Development Plan, and under that plan, we were told to regionalize, to look for areas all over the country, so that we will decongest the here in New Bilibid prison.
And I understand your predicament, because what's difficult is, even if you own the land, regardless of where you build, LGUs don't essentially want, right, inmates or convicts in their area. So you face a bigger challenge. What would you need now? Because ang tanong nito, the Masungi Geo Reserve, for example, if the UP urban planners or experts can assure that the area would still be protected, would you recommend or push to build there?
Yeah, I will recommend that we push through with it without violating the ecological environment. In as much as this is a property that we also have to move into. Right now, we don't have facilities near. What I intend to do is, because the bulk of our PDL are from Metro Manila. So I need a prison colony north of Metro Manila and also south of Metro Manila, because the intent of the guidance is to make sure that the PDLs are also near their relatives, which means they have to be incarcerated or put in the place near where they are living, where they came from.
Of the 270 hectares that BuCor owns, I'm curious, how many were you planning to use?
Initially, maybe 20 to 30 hectares, not at the foot of the mountain or at the mountain itself, but the vacant spaces down the mountain, in as much as it is a better place to develop it.
Have you actually discussed this and met with the Masungi Geo Reserve Foundation? Because their fears are this project would go against the sustainable development agenda of the area, right? So ang tanong ko, nag-usap na po ba kayo? Because they claim that the area is mountainous and geologically unbuildable. Dito pwede magtayo daw doon.
Maybe in the exact location that they are now, but we still have to find out the other location because it's really a big place. 270 hectares is a big place.
Are there any other areas within Luzon that you feel is a possibility and would need presidential intervention?
I think so. Because when I was the chief of staff of the armed forces, I saw three big areas.
Apo.
One in Luzon, which is in Fort Magsaysay. In fact, when I was already the commander of 7th Division, at that time, it was the year 2013, they were looking for a place where they can really put up the new Bilibid prison. Unfortunately, they did not push through. We allocated about 500 hectares in Fort Magsaysay.
So don't you want to build there? What about Fort Magsaysay? How do you feel? Why not there?
I think it's better there, but it's north of Metro Manila. North of Metro Manila. So, but the documents there are not yet finalized. There's no proclamation. That's why
BuCor doesn't own it. BuCor doesn't own Fort Magsaysay.
Yeah, you don't own it. If a presidential declaration can be made, declaring some portions of Fort Magsaysay as a penal or a prison and a penal farm, we would like to be there. Because now I'm faced with a bigger problem of what to do with our PDLs. You know, our PDLs, we spent approximately 120,000 each per year for them. And they are just staying in a congested area. They're getting sick.
It's inhuman.
They have to be moved out.
And it's inhuman. It's not rehabilitative in nature already.
Yes.
Kasi I've been to the Bilibid a few times as a reporter. So naiintindihan ko po kayo, sir.
Thank you for understanding us.
Ang tanong lang talaga is how do you balance? So you have two options. Number one, you need one in Luzon. So they're near their relatives. So Geo, 270 hectares is titled to BuCor. So technically speaking, you do have a right to build there. Technically speaking, but you have not yet spoken with the stakeholders, you have not met with them. The other option is Fort Magsaysay, which is north, but still at least drivable, and it's you can go there by land. Ang problema, hindi kayo may ari nun.
Yes, yes.
Sino may ari nun, sir?
It's owned by the Department of National Defense.
So they would have to donate it. Or trade it, depends. And the only way that can happen is if you do have a presidential proclamation.
Yes, that will be part of our, hopefully we'll be able to have a meeting together with the Secretary of Justice, a meeting with the President to iron out these issues, in as much as there are two laws that were passed. One law passed in 2013, regionalizing all the prison colonies except for NCR.
Tama kayo doon.
And then another law, which was passed just by this previous administration, telling us to put up the heinous crime facilities, one in Luzon, one in the Visayas, and one in Mindanao. So these are big tasks that we have to do. That's why we're looking for lands that can be made available to us.
And frankly speaking, ang Bilibid is now at 30,000 inmates. Ang capacity lang niya talaga, tama ba ko, sir, is one-third of it?
Nasa 96,000.
Yun ang tunay na capacity niya, right?
Yes, that's the livable capacity.
Opo. So, okay. So one is Fort Magsaysay. If the president actually issues a proclamation, that would solve your problems.
Yes.
Oo. Are there other sites in Luzon? Or yun na po yun?
I'm looking down south in Quezon also.
Okay.
So that those who are from south of Metro Manila, they can also be very near. Because what we have now, south of Luzon or south of Metro Manila is in Mindoro. And they will have to cross the island going there. Oh. So tawid dagat yon, that will be more problematic for them. And that Mindoro is designed as directed by our Secretary of Justice to be the maximum supermax prison area.
Mm-mm.
One in Luzon, that will be one in Luzon.
I'm curious, sir, there have been recommendations that even our prisons should be privatized. Do you see that in the Philippines?
Well, that's something to look forward to. Let's arrange.
What is the model? In other words, if you privatize our local prisons, how would the investor or the business owner make a profit off that? Ano yung modelo dun?
I think the model right now is what we can look at is the Indabao, the Tadeco, wherein we have about 500 hectares leased to the Tadeco, the one supplying the bananas.
Mm-mm.
They pay about 30 million a month.
Mm.
And easily, if somebody is really willing to be part of this privatization, it will be good, but it will take a while. We have to address first the problems inside the New Bilibid or in BuCor, and then maybe it becomes a viable option. We can privatize this in the future.
Okay. So you believe in privatization as well. So moving forward, what is your plan? You will be contacting already experts from UP, which is a good move. So then you can talk about the viability of actually building in Masungi Reserve, if it's possible, if it won't harm the environment. But will you also meet with the Masungi Geo Reserve Foundation?
Of course, we are willing to sit down with them, to talk with them. In fact, there are already intermediaries. We're putting up a chat group to really discuss this informally, and maybe for when the time comes, we can discuss this sitting down face to face.
Okay. Before we go, very quickly, just recently, I know Justice Secretary, he spoke at an event where more than 400 prisoners were released, right? That was yesterday. And it's part of the ongoing effort to decongest Bilibid. Ano po ba ang problema? Other than, of course, talagang we need a new site. But when it comes to setting the inmates free, at least on that end, what can be improved?
I think the the Board of Parole and Pardon should come in.
Uh-oh.
And they'll be the one to recommend to the president those who can be given parole and clemency. Mm-hmm. Inasmuch as parole and clemency can be given out after you have served the minimum time.
Uh-oh.
Let's say if you are to be incarcerated for 20 years, you already served 10 years, half of it.
And let's say hindi naman hinyos, diba?
Yes.
Pero ang tanong ko, isn't that ongoing? Isn't the Board of Parole and Pardons, aren't they active? Like every week they're actually there studying the cases, or they're not that active?
Yeah, they're doing that in coordination with the BuCor.
So what is needed is the president's approval all the time.
Yeah. Some of these have to be approved by the president.
So dapat kumbaga mas mabilis. But I mean, offhand, sa nagdaang presidente, ito rin naman ang problema.
Yes.
Uh-oh. Based on your recommendations, you're there, you know the population. 400 inmates were released Monday. Ilan dapat ang nare-release sa totoo lang every week or every month?
Hopefully we can add more. Maybe 500 per month will be
per
good.
Month. Uh-oh.
Yes.
No, that would make a difference. If you release 500 a month, it would mean that at least by the end of the year, you'll have 6,000 inmates out. It's yes. Lalo na for those with lesser crimes.
Yes, of course.
Oh, and what would be needed, sir? Because who knows, you know, mamaya matupad yung hiling ninyo on Fort Magsaysay and the release of 500 a month. On both that, you need the president.
Yeah. Unfortunately, Karen, the rate of released versus the rate of those who are coming in over a period of time is also faster for those who are coming in. There's a lot of crime being committed. Most of them are even drug-related. It's a big problem. We have to address our drug problem to also lower down the criminality that will force them to be put on jail.
All right. Well, on that note, I do hope to speak with you again, sir. At least you can update us on this particular issue. I want to thank you, Acting BuCor Director General Gregorio Catapang Jr., for joining me today. Thank you, sir.
My pleasure.
All right.